Are you looking to install Windows operating system in your dedicated server? It can be Kimsufi, it can be OVH, it can be SoYouStart. But the problem is most of this server provider does not give you a one-click or easy installation for Windows operating system like they do for Linux variants. In this video, I will show you how you can install Windows operating system of your choice in just 6 steps without any technical knowledge, and you can install it in remote where you don't need to physically have access to your dedicated server. Hi guys, it's Alston. Before I go into the video, if you find this video useful, please do give a like, and also if you like to watch more videos like this or from me every week, please do subscribe and hit the bell notifications to get updated. Okay, the first step is go into your control panel of your dedicated server. Inside that, find an option called NetBoot. Inside that, go into it and find a rescue mode available. Make sure it is selected for Rescue 64 Pro and click on Save and exit that pop-up window. Step 2. Now go into the control panel again and make sure you hit disable the server monitoring. By default it will be enabled. Go inside that and disable it, then restart or reboot your dedicated server, and you need to wait 5 to 10 minutes where you will be receiving an email which is connected to your account. It will contain rescue access detail. You can ignore most of the parts of the email. All we are interested in is IP address, username and password, and make a note of it. We will be using step 3, where this is an important step where you need to have something called Windows image template to install it on your server. Now there are two ways of getting this about. One is the easy way but less secure, where you can find others who have done it for you, where they have created an image template file. There are so many resources. All you need to do is go into Google and search something like Windows image template for Kimsufi, OVH or dedicated server. You will find a lot of resources. But the drawback is that you should be able to trust this source, because as someone else has created for you, even though you can activate your using license, but the problem is there can be malware, there can be viruses or any backdoor or spyware. So if you are going into this kind of a route, you should make sure that you are fully trusting that provider of that image template file. Even if you do, a recommendation tip is to make sure to do a full virus cleaning and also change all the username passwords once that is installed. Now for the second step, which is creating your own image template file, where this is much more secure, but it contains more works as you can imagine. The option is to creating your image file, where there are so many ways of doing it. You can search on the internet for it, you will find it. If you like me to do that, drop a yes in the comment. I will make sure to create an upcoming video on that as well. So that is the step 1. You will be having a Windows image template file. You will have something called GZ file format, where you will have to host this particular image Windows template file in a publicly available websites, where it's a downloadable file without any authorization. Step 4. Now you need to use a free SSH client such as Bitwise and PuTTY to connect to your server. You need to download this particular application and insert the IP address, username and password you got it from rescue email. And all you need to do is enter a single piece of line. You don't need to know the full technical knowledge of it. Basically, I am showing it currently on the video. I will leave it on the description as well. All you need to do is, once you are logged into your server with using the SSH client, just paste this line and make sure to replace the URL before you paste to the where your image file is hosted, and just click on enter. Now what it will do is it will download that particular file into your server and extract that into your dedicated server. Once that is done, we are now good to go and start connecting to our server. Step 5. Since Windows is now installed in your server, you need to go back into the control panel and make sure to turn off the rescue mode NetBoot and turn it back to the hard disk to load the operating system from the internal disk itself. So make sure to select hard disk as the boot option and make sure to restart it, and you need to wait couple of minutes to get that server back. Step 6 is, now you have managed to install the server, it's now currently live. Now all you need to do is just connect to your server, where you can do this by using a free utility tool which is pre-built on Windows app operating systems. And if you are using a different operating system like Linux and Mac, there are so many free alternatives to do that as well. You can usually find this in Windows Inside Accessories menu. Inside that, open up the remote desktop connection, paste in your IP and the username and password for the Windows image template file you done, and just click on connect. And you can also remember the details so you don't need to type username and password every single time. And that's it. Basically, now you have installed a Windows operating system of your choice to your dedicated server panel. If you manage to do it, do drop a yes in the comments so I do know that you have done this particular one correctly. If you are experiencing some problems or issues, do ask me on the comments. I will try to help you. Or you can join our private Facebook community, where you can ask me, and other members also can help you on this as well. Once again, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.